Hi, I'm Emily Rose.
And I'm Dan Philgreen. Welcome to the weekend edition of ShellPoint Today for December 6th, 7th, and 8th.
On today's show, we'll get a preview of an Italian luncheon. We'll learn about making gravy.
Obviously, gravy has to be thickened, but the thing is, in order to thicken your gravy, you have to make a little bit of a roux.
And we'll round out the week with a devotional from Chaplain Sonny Torres.
Was it the decorations, the unique family traditions, the parties, the Christ child story, the presents?
But before we get into that, let's look back into history for a minute. It was on this day in 1884 in Washington, D.C., that workers placed a 9-inch aluminum pyramid atop a tower of white marble, completing the construction of an impressive monument to the city's namesake and the nation's first president, George Washington. As early as 1783, the infant U.S. Congress decided that a statue of George Washington, the great Revolutionary War general, should be erected. But it was 33 years after Washington's death that anybody really did anything about it. Construction would not begin until 1848, and it was halted after 6 years due to a lack of funds and other distractions, such as the Civil War. Finally, in 1876, the centennial of American independence, President Ulysses S. Grant authorized the construction to be completed. Made of some 36,000 blocks of marble and granite, stacked 555 feet in the air, the monument was the tallest structure in the world at the time of its completion in December 1884. A city law passed in 1910 restricted the height of new buildings to ensure that the monument will always remain the tallest structure in Washington, D.C., a fitting tribute to the man known as the father of his country. Today, more than 800,000 people visit the monument each year.
I have visited that monument, and I did not know that that was the tallest building in D.C.
And it always will be, apparently.
It's very fitting. Well, on Monday, the sound of Christmas bells is coming to ShellPoint. The Southwest Florida Handbell Ensemble is dedicated to excellence in ringing and promoting handbell music to all audiences. Ring in the holiday with the seasonal concert, which will feature 5 octaves of handbells and hand chimes. Sign up for this free concert is required. Simply contact any concierge desk, and the concert will be on Monday at 3 p.m. in the Social Center on the island.
Don't forget that Monday is the dinner outing to Blanc. Blanc is, of course, the French word for white. Chef Jean-Claude, the owner of the French restaurant called Blanc, really does love the color white. The motif of the room is everything white. Even Jean-Claude's glasses are white. It's a fun place to enjoy some really great food. Give one of the concierge desks a call today to see if there's any room left for this delicious trip.
While we're talking about delicious food, another tasty trip is on the horizon a week from today on December 13th. This time, we're going Italian, and the destination is Cafe Toscano.